Good afternoon. Welcome to the November 11th Veterans Day meeting of the Rotary Club of Des Moines. I'm President Catherine Staub, and we are delighted to have you here today. Thank you to Dave Dixon, who signed up to give us a moment of inspiration, followed by the pledge and the four-way test. Dave?
Today we recognize veterans who serve in the armed forces. All chose, or at least acquiesced, to such service for the benefit of all citizens, including those who couldn't, wouldn't, or didn't serve. They did this to preserve the ideals stated in the Constitution and Bill of Rights, and for the preservation of the nation. Some gave their lives, some lost their health through injuries and diseases, some were disfigured or lost their mental capabilities. They faced hardships, fears, and doubts. It is fitting that we acknowledge their efforts and sacrifices for the benefit of all citizens. It is fitting that we thank them for their service.
To the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Is it true?
It's a fair and all concern. Will it build goodwill and better friendships? Will it be beneficial to all concerned?
Thank you, Dave, for the fitting tribute to our veterans today. And on that note, would all of our veterans who are with us please stand at this time so we can thank you for your service.
I've looked forward to the program today for a long time. Slightly over a year ago, my sister Linda is here with me today, and you can give her your condolences later. We're introduced to quotes about my cousin, sponsored a quote for our dad, and also for her dad, who did live long enough to make the presentation. It was a beautiful September day in City Park, in the town where he grew up. It couldn't have been, there were he and 11 other veterans. And he was the oldest at 92. And timing was perfect because Dad passed just shortly after turning 93. But it was a perfect day, perfect presentation. Dad didn't get moved by too much stuff. And we had to actually cajole him a little bit to even go because of COVID. They missed that together. But because it was outdoors, and we told him he could wear his mask, and he went, and he was glad that he did. So that led me to finding out more about quotes about. And to that, I was met Catherine Jones. Catherine is a retired Iowa State Administrator with 40 years of service at ISU. She retired in 2013 as the University Registrar Emeritus and Associate Vice President of Student Affairs. She enjoys quilting, which is convenient for her group that she represents. and is a member of Colson Valor Foundation and has been for 5 years. In the past 3 years, she has served as the Iowa coordinator for Colson Valor. Her and her husband, Steve, are both members of the Rotary Club of Ames and are both our Paul Harris Society members. Please help me welcome Kathy.
Good afternoon. I'm very happy to be able to speak to you today on this topic. I actually got involved in Quilson Valor as a result of a speech by our then national director for Quilson Valor, who was from Ames at the time. And she inspired me to start doing what she was doing, and eventually I became the Iowa coordinator, which has been a good fit for me. I'm a board administrator, so that's kind of what I do. So today I'm going to talk to you about thanking our veterans with Quilts of Valor. That's what it's all about. It's about saying thank you. And then I'm going to start with some photos of past presentations, people that received Quilts of Valor, and a little bit about the stories, because they illustrate different types of ceremonies and the range of individuals who are recognized with Quilts of Valor. And the first one on the upper left is Anson Muffler, who was from Ottumwa, Iowa. He was 96, I believe, at the time that he was awarded his quilt. He was a World War II veteran captured in Northern Africa, and he was in a camp in Poland for 3 or 4 years. And eventually came back. He was somewhat connected to my husband, who was a commander in the first of the 133 out of Waterloo Cedar Falls. And this gentleman, Anton, had also been in that battalion when he was in it during World War II. Red Bull, if you've ever heard of Red Bulls, that's who they were. So Steve went along with me and they connected, and he didn't know, I don't think, that he was getting the Quilt of Valor, not because he hadn't been told, but I don't think he remembered things well. But he was so excited that day and so proud of that quilt. He's since passed away. The middle picture on the top actually is two Steves. One is my husband, Steve, and the other is my daughter's father-in-law, Steve. So my grandsons have two Steve grandfathers, who both of whom were veterans. My husband served in the National Guard for 30 plus years and retired as a colonel. The other Steve was in Vietnam, and I believe he was in the trucking business over there, taking supplies to the troops. So they were awarded their quilts at a family event, to show a family event. These are pretty common where you have multiple people from the same family who are recognized in a home ceremony and given their quilts at that time. And it always makes a really nice touch. And sometimes you get quite a few relatives that come in order to be there to celebrate. And I'm not sure, my slide is a little different. I think the third one is just a picture of the quilt. I've modified my slides, but I made my file too big, so we couldn't see the modified ones today. Down below that, on the left, is a Ryman Gardens group. And every fall, Ryman Gardens in Ames has a quilt show. And included in that is a presentation of Quilts of Valor. They will hang the Quilts of Valor that are donated for the event and show them as part of the exhibit. And then at the end of the exhibit, they have an award ceremony. And there's always a few. It's not ever a really big group, but they have people come from all over the state and receive Quilts of Valor at that time. So this ceremony was, I think, in 2018. And then the last one is just my information. I left cards on the desk at the entrance, and I'm guessing some of you will have questions. And so that's probably the best way to get a hold of me, although I'll hopefully leave time for questions at the end of this presentation. But I'm Kathleen.Jones at QOVF .org, for quotes of that organization.org. Okay, this is the Tulsa Valor homepage. And so if you go to QOVF.org, this is where you land. And there are different versions depending on what you're using, whether you're on a phone or a computer and how big it is. So at any rate, one of the things it will display is the mission of Tulsa Valor. And our mission is to cover service members and veterans touched by war with comforting and healing quotes of valor. So it's living service members and veterans. And I say that because there are times when, and it happened with my father-in-law, we have a quote already to present. He was my first quote. He was very ill when I heard the presentation that Anne had given the names. And I thought, why do you need to get him a quote? He was in World War II in the Philippines in 1946, spent a year there. And so I got busy and I found a pattern and made a quilt, and I got it done. And the day I finished it, I got the call and done. So the next day, we headed off to Nebraska. And I gave the quilt to my mother-in-law. She had it at the funeral home with all of his family items and military items that she wanted to have on display for the visitors at the funeral home. Now, normally, we don't give quotes of valor to those that have passed, but if it happens in close succession to when you were going to present it anyway, it can be done as long as it meets all of the criteria for being a quote of valor. So he received his quilt, never got to see it, but my mother-in-law loves it, uses it all the time. Fulfilling the mission, as I said, the website is qovf.org. We do have a national headquarters. It's currently in Winterset, so not too far from here. The reason I say currently is we just got a new executive director who lives in Colorado. And it is always possible that the headquarters might go where the director is as opposed to the other way around. It's a 501c3. It's rated 100 out of 100 by Charity Navigator. So make good use of the funds that are available to the organization. All of the work is done by volunteers. And so there's approximately 550 registered members. And that's just in Iowa. Plus lots of people who are involved with Quotes of Valor who are not necessarily members. They may make blocks, they may help put the quilts together, they may be involved in presentations, but they just really don't want to be a member, and they'll support those who are. So we have a lot of people involved just in the state of Iowa. We currently have 28 groups, and that would be an association of people in a local area, usually, where they work together to create and present the Quilts of Valor. There are 6 Iowa quilt shops that are affiliated officially with Quilts of Valor. And so they have some special things that they do as a result of that. So it's a volunteer model for this organization. One person makes the top, although it might be made with pieces from many different people. And someone else quilts it, which is the process of putting the top, the batting, and the bottom together and sewing it with some sort of a pattern. And then at the end it has to be mounted to hold it all together. So each of those steps is likely to be done by somebody different. And as a group, we end up creating a finished product, which is a quilt of valor. Nationally, we've awarded about 281,000 quilts of valor since 2003, which is when the organization was founded. That number keeps changing, and this week is huge. There are so many quilts of valor presented during Veterans Day week. And my email is just popping with information on nominations that were completed. There we go. Touched by War. There's been quite a bit of discussion in the organization over the years about who should be awarded a Quilt of Valor. It's not a gift, it is an award. There's a whole process that goes along with it, including a script that is read. And you'll get to hear that because you're going to see a presentation of the quilt to someone who's no longer with us and who's not here today. But I want you to feel what it feels like to be at the Quilt of Valor ceremony. So I'll be doing that in a few minutes. That armed service members or veterans know what Touched by War means. And it may mean different things to different people. Technically, it can be anyone who has been in the military, whether National Guard, Reserves, active duty, doesn't really matter. But somehow they need to feel that they have been touched by war. And there are a lot of different ways that that can happen, and it's a very individualized thing. And as the association says, we honor their wishes and don't judge. It actually was quite a serious point of contention about a year ago because we had some who would award to absolutely anyone and others who felt if you didn't get shot at, you didn't deserve a Quilt of Valor. So somehow we had to come together as an organization and find a happy middle on that, which I think they've successfully done. Yes, I missed that. The Quilt of Valor nomination process, if you go to QOBF.org, which is that main site, there one of the selections is nominations and awards. Click on that, and then there is a place to nominate. And it'll tell you what information is needed. You can self-nominate, or you can nominate someone else that you feel should be awarded a Quilt of Valor. If that happens to be an Iowa person, it gets routed to me, then I find the right group in Iowa to route it to, and hopefully they take over at that point in time and then make an award somewhere near their locale or the person's locale. There's no award ceremony, so Memorial Day, that's the one day of the year that is designed to be an event to honor those who are no longer with us. And so it's outside of the mission of Quilt of Valor, and we don't award that day because it could cause confusion as to what we're doing. So what happens, the Quilt of Valor member or volunteer reads a script, and there's a history of Quilt of Valor, which I will be reading to you. Quilt equals healing is kind of the main message. And then we talk to the veteran about what it means to receive a Quilt of Valor and hopefully make them feel good about their service. I was involved with an award in a little bit west of here a couple weeks ago, and it was a gentleman who now lives in Alaska, but he had served in Vietnam. And actually, I talk about that in the end, but I always ask if there's anything the veteran wants to say. And this gentleman didn't have anything at that point, but then right about when we were done, he said, I do have something I want to say. I said, okay, so he said, well, he said, I came back from Vietnam on a plane. He said, I was welcomed home three times. The first time was in the airport, where there were young people throwing stones at me. And then he said, I went home, and my wife welcomed me. And now, 53 years later, I feel welcomed again. So that was pretty special. That one was a little harder, but it was very much from the heart. So let's see. So I'm going to do a presentation. Where are we on time? We should be okay. This usually takes about 20, 25 minutes. I won't take that long, I don't think. I tried to cut out a little bit. But we are going to award a Quilt of Valor, and the quilt is here. I have a certificate if anybody wants to see what those look like. And when the quilt is awarded, we also give the veteran a certificate that says this is an official Quilt of Valor. So I'll begin with how the ceremony would start. The Quilt of Valor Foundation is a national organization founded in 2003 by Blue Star Mom, Catherine Roberts, literally with a dream. Her son Nat was deployed in Iraq, and she said she was 10 seconds away from panic, 24 hours a day. Her dream was as vivid as real life, and she said, "I saw a young man sitting on the side of his bed in the middle of the night, hunched over. The overall feeling was one of utter despair. Then, as if viewing a movie, I saw him in the next scene, wrapped in a quilt. His whole demeanor had changed from one of despair to one of hope and well-being. The quilt had made the change, and the message of her dream was that quilts equals healing, which I mentioned before, and the Quilts of Valor Foundation grew out of that dream. Since the Quilts of Valor Foundation was founded in 2003, approximately 290,000, my number jumps around depending on how I look, Quilts of Valor have been awarded in every state in the United States, plus Germany, Iraq, and Afghanistan. So far this year, over 21,000 Quilts of Valor have been awarded, and we're not done with the year yet. So then we turn to the veteran, or veterans as it may be. Quilts of Valor bring a three-part message from our hearts. First, Quilts of Valor are awarded to honor you for your service, raising the right hand and taking that oath and leading all that you hold dear. Next, Quilts of Valor are meant to say thank you for that service, sacrifice, and valor in serving our nation. And finally, Quilts of Valor are meant to offer healing, peace, comfort, and warmth to the individual who receives it, and for them to know that their service was appreciated. Each Quilt of Valor includes a label that provides information about that quilt. And as of the day that that quilt is awarded, the story of the quilt becomes that veteran's story. We hope that you will keep this quilt with you as a reminder that there are thousands of women and men across this land who are forever in your debt. Though we may never know the depth of your sacrifice to protect and defend the United States of America, as an expression of gratitude for a grateful nation, we are humbled to be awarding you the Quilt of Valor today. Now, if this was an actual presentation, we would then proceed to recognize the service of each veteran. Today, we have a remembrance presentation. I've never done one of these before, but it works. And it's to Randy Worth's father, who was awarded his quilt in 2020. Yeah. And so this quilt was awarded to Robert Worth. If this was an actual presentation, this is when Robert would be asked to come forward and be wrapped with a quilt. And thank you to Randy for bringing Robert's quilt today for us to see and to share in honor of his father. Robert Boyd Worth was drafted into the United States Army during the Korean conflict. He served 2 years, from November 1, 1950 to October 31 of 1952. He was based out of Fort Monmouth, New Jersey, and he was a radio communications expert using his electrical engineering background. At the time of his discharge, he had achieved the rank of sergeant. Robert Worth, on behalf of the Quilts of Valor Foundation, you were awarded this Quilt of Valor to recognize you for your service in the United States Army. In addition to your quilt, you received a certificate that documented that you were awarded a Quilt of Valor. Every Quilt of Valor award is different and as unique as the veteran being honored. There's a label on Robert's quilt with the names of those who contributed to the making of that quilt. From a grateful nation and from the Quilts of Valor Foundation, thank you very much for your service. May this quilt keep you safe and warm. And then there's always time for hugs. Now, COVID has made Quilts of Valor a difficult thing during the last couple of years. We've had a lot of groups that quit meeting to make quilts. They quit having award ceremonies because of their caution, and I agree with that. And the organization basically said to the individual groups, you do what you need to do to be comfortable and safe. So there were a lot of changes made over the last couple of years, but we have persisted and things are finally starting to get back to normal. Although I was just mentioning to someone even now that I am scheduling a Quilt of Valor presentation, first thing I ask is, what is the vaccination status of people that will be in attendance? Because even though I've had a booster, I want to know and if I need to be wearing a mask, I will. If not, I want to know that I'm safe. And so I expect that most of our people are doing that. So that's what a presentation would look like. And so I had some testaments. If I find that sheet in here, which I may not do, is the testament that I already mentioned. The gentleman who talked about the three times he was welcomed home. Okay, somehow that page is not in here. So I will let you read here we go. Recent comment from an Iowa veteran. This was the one. He was welcomed home three times. And as I said, that one blew me away. Another comment, God bless all the volunteers who bring joy and light to this dark tunnel, in our veterans' face. We are so honored by your kindness. And lastly, I hope you will pass this on to the dedicated quilters in our community and elsewhere to let them know that their hard work is appreciated. I was told by a quilter once that quilters take this very seriously and perform their work with a sense of honor. I hope that they know that the veterans and their families receive it with the same feelings. And I say that they do know that. The people that I've worked across the state are very, very much committed to this program and to the veterans that they work with as they make their presentations. And quilts, the variety is tremendous. Almost never do you see two that are just alike. So now I do have time for questions, and I didn't get into a lot of the nuts and bolts kinds of stuff, but if you have questions about how to do anything or how to get involved, and I normally don't talk about donations, but if anybody is interested, there's information on the homepage, and they can go directly to Winter Set. So thank you for inviting me, and I hope this is something that will help you understand what we do. And I'll mention I have a grandson today who is he's a geospatial intelligence specialist serving in the Marines in near Urasawa, Japan, which is Camp Kinzer. So I'm thinking a lot about him today. He's been there for a few months and he'll be there a total of 3 years. I didn't know what geospatial intelligence was, but basically he analyzes images from satellites or drones and makes maps that they can use for deployments or whatever. So being a grandparent and seeing what your grandchildren can do through the US military is just amazing. And it's added to my appreciation for all that they do for us in the world. Definitely they're in peril because of what they have been involved in. So we would love to see nominations from anyone in that situation or for anyone in that situation if they're supported.
Could you go back and explain the nomination process again and how that, who analyzes that, and then how that moves forward to a quilt presentation?
The process on the web is pretty self-explanatory. The question is about the nomination process and how it works. You go to the web, qobf.org, and go to nominations and awards. It walks you through everything. It tells you what you're going to need to submit. Basically, you need to make sure that the veteran knows that they're going to receive a quilt of valor and that they're okay with that, and ask them if they, for any reason, object or do they feel touched by the work. And then with that, it's a matter of knowing when did they serve, what was their rank, where did they serve. And so the way the website is structured now, if somebody submits it, as far as I'm concerned, they're eligible because they had to go through enough checks along the way to make sure that they're really eligible to receive a quilt of valor. But you do need to know something about their service, like where they were when they were there, awards. I got one just today that was a Purple Heart recipient from Vietnam. Right now, I'm a bit worried about the war veterans who have been involved in that conflict who are now in maybe a questionable state, and I'm not trying to be political, but who may wonder about how much their contribution was valued. And I think that's a really good group to be honoring right now. We also need to keep honoring our World War II veterans. There are not very many left, and so that's another group that is, I'm not seeing too many. I've seen some in the last month that are coming through, either as already awarded or just being nominated. But the process is not difficult. It walks you through it. But be prepared to read it and then say, oh, I need that, and then go do that, and then come back. And that's okay, because you don't have to actually submit until you're done. Other questions?
How long from the nomination to actually receiving the quilt is it usually? Obviously, making a quilt takes time.
We say 6 months at the outside, but it really depends, at least in Iowa, it depends on where in the state. There are areas of the state that are not well covered. And so, usually getting the quilts is not as much of an issue as finding someone who has the time to drive to a remote location that they have no reason to go to. Across the state, we have very good cooperation with sharing quilts. I may have someone in Western Iowa who has lots of nominations and needs to be awarding quilts, someone in Eastern Iowa who has lots of quilts, but they're all caught up. So we have a webpage that we use to keep together and try to coordinate those who are on the upside of things and those who are needing help. So it works out pretty well.
I think you said that every quilt is different, is that correct? And who designs, comes up with the color patterns and designs to do the quilt?
It's totally the quilter. I mean, there are lots of sites that have designs. And you better believe that when I leave today, I'll know how to put that quilt together. Because we're always, even though they're never the same, just having something made in a similar way with different fabrics will make it be completely different. So there's probably, I don't know, probably more than thousands, probably tens of thousands of designs out there that have been used. And the fabric just needs to be, for the most part, patriotic colors. But that's, it can be gold, it can be khaki green. I mean, there's lots of colors that are not necessarily red, white, and blue that that's still fit for a quilt of valor. But that, this one's beautiful. I quilted that, but I don't know how to put that together without even thinking about it, but I just need a picture to remind me how it's assembled. Other questions? Well, for those of you that aren't veterans, if you haven't received one, and if you're interested, please nominate yourself. And right now, the other thing I would mention in terms of timing is we have a lot of members who are snowbirders. I'm probably the average age of a Quilt of Valor member. We don't get a lot of really young members, and there are quite a few that are quite a bit older than me. So, but some are gone from November through end of March, and then they'll come back. And often when they're down from me in Texas or down in Florida, they're involved with the Quilt of Valor group down there, and they're still awarding. But it's not necessarily contributing to our Iowa mission, and that's just fine. That's life in Iowa. Other questions? Well, thank you very much for the opportunity to speak with you. And as I said, send me a text, send me an email. My email sometimes deletes things I don't understand. So if I don't answer right away, you can get back to me and I'll answer the next time. Thank you.
We are adjourned.